And the challenge is that he can't just win New York by a point or two. That's not good enough. The entire nature of the
winning, although the conversation would change. You're right from the delegate math standpoint. But if he beats Hillary Clinton in New York, we're going to be having a very different conversation at this table the Sunday after that.
Yes, and the race would surely go into the convention, and it would he'd never drop out. But the problem is that Democrats have set up this race in a way that favors the person who establishes a large lead from the outset.
Really? Right.
And it's hard to, when you're playing on those kind of rules, it's hard to climb out of a hole, because even if you win, if you don't win overwhelmingly, it's not enough. And we saw that just yesterday, where he wins in Wyoming, a great state for him, and they split delegates.
Yeah, right. Basically, his team thinks, okay, maybe we come close in New York, or we win by a little bit, then they move into these north states that they don't think they have a chance for. They're looking for when the race moves back out west to Oregon. Right. To California. They hope they can rack up big wins there and then make the case that he's more electable than her in a general election and have all these superdelegates switch sides.
Yes.
It's just hard to see that playing out given the institutional biases built into the process towards the person who, as you point out, establishes a big lead.
And he has